news story over the weekend is the arrest of somebody in the brutal beating of Brian Stowe at Dodger Stadium. Giovanni Ramirez is the man who was arrested. He is apparently an ex-con, a documented gang member, according to the LA Times. With us to talk about part of this is Alex Alonso. He is a person who has researched gangs for years and years, president and founder of StreetGangs.com. He worked on the New York gangs. Now he's been working on the LA gangs a long time. Alex, good morning. There's a little bit of both kind of a code and fear that kept information from being disseminated in this case. Am I overstating?
I think you might be overstating a little bit that, you know, we don't know who knew what he was involved in. I wouldn't expect his family to turn him in. Most situations, regardless if there's a gang member or a non-gang member, you're not going to get your mother or father turning you over to the police immediately. So I don't think it's unusual that it took almost 2 months to find this individual.
So it was a parole agent that gave the tip?
Yes, it was. It was a parole agent that I believe noticed he had matched the description of the composite drawing. I think he noticed that there was a birthmark on his face, and then I think the tattoos on his neck. You know, the tattoos are going to stand out, especially if you have them on your neck. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what led him to the arrest.
I was saying earlier that part of it was the observation that there were new tattoos, perhaps trying to cover up the old tattoos that police were looking for. Have you heard that?
Yeah, there could have been some tattoos that would identify him more easily, and he went and got some new tattoos. And when you get a new tattoo, it's pretty fresh. You got to apply lubricant, so it's going to shine. So it's kind of hard to hide a brand new tattoo, especially on the neck.
So the parole officer saw that, and red flag went up. Such a reward for this. Do the parole officers get it? How does this work?
You're asking the wrong person. I have no idea how that money gets disseminated. I think it has to do with people in the public turning them over. So I'm sure they can use the money because it took 6,000 hours of LAPD detectives spending probably anywhere around $300,000 to $500,000 just to find a beating suspect.
Wow.
Alex, we pay attention intermittently to the gang situation here in Los Angeles. I would say 10 years ago we paid much more attention to it. Was it worse then? Has it been alleviated, or are we just looking elsewhere?
Well, yeah, 10, 15, 20 years ago it was way worse than it is now. Crime rate was like three times than it is now in certain neighborhoods. So I wouldn't say the problem's alleviated or it's gone away, but we have one of the safest cities in the United States. We have one of the lowest crime rates of a large city. We have over 4 million people in the city, over 10 million in the region, and we only had about 300 murders. I know 300 sounds like a lot, but when you compare it to many cities across this country, LA, Los Angeles has one of the lowest murder rates in all of America.
Alex, what are the chances now, because you understand this gang culture, of the other two, or especially the other one guy, being arrested now as a result of this? Will this guy who's in custody talk? Is it not how it works? Is there a hierarchy? Will, you know, his family be repercussions if he does say who the other guy is?
Well, I think that if he's the primary aggressor, as Chief Charlie Beck said yesterday at the press conference, he's probably not going to implicate anyone else, especially the female driver. I'm sure he's perceiving the female driver as someone that's completely innocent.
Right.
And if the second individual, the second male, was just a lesser involved person, he'll probably take the responsibility, deal with it himself, and exercise his right to remain silent.
Okay.
Alex Alonso, your group is called StreetGangs.com. We thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you very much.
Okay.